Hello everyone, this is Steve Colonna says Cookie, and welcome back to one of the another DRL Geico Elimination Series races. And this time, we're here at Watkins Glen for round 4 of the series. And then right after we're done with this race, we'll still gonna be going forward to Watkins Glen for the 23rd race of the Chips Ahoy Cup Series. So, Roger James is one of our previous winners who just won the Boston race of round 3. And after we hit round 3, we end up seeing 4 drivers that are already eliminated as Mark Martenzie, Gary Preston, Warren Miles, and Nelson Reeves. Again, I apologize for spelling the last name wrong, but I think I figured out how to spell Martenzie this time. So, yeah. So yeah, 4 of those drivers are in the cutoff. And same thing, but yeah, they got screwed for the most part. And now we currently have 60 drivers at Watkins Glen, since 16 of them can't continue to do more races, except for 4 drivers that are already eliminated. So yeah, Andrew Miller, Siggy Rhodes, Andrew Williams, and Charlie Davenport are also at the cutoff, so they either need to get a win or a better position, and hopefully they will get more points. And if they don't, they will also get screwed as well for round 4, round 5, and round 6. By the end of round 6, for the most part. So, anyways, here is your starting grid for tonight's race. So, round 1, we got Charlie Davenport and Brandon Hancock. Then round 2, we got Rory Overton and Roger James, our previous winner. Round 3, we got William Brock and Kaylee Hancock. Round 4, we got Roberto Crown Jr. and Ziggy Rhodes. Row 5, we got Jonathan Wong and Owen Crafton. Row 6, am I correct? No, row 7, excuse me. Row 7, Brandon Nelson and... Actually, it's row 6. Oh my goodness, I'm confusing y'all. Row 6 is Brandon Nelson and Logan Williams. Then row 7 is Cameron Hathaway and Brady Wilmington. And then, finally for the last row at row 8 is Andrew Williams and Andrew Miller. And it's the Andrew Show. Nah, not really. I just had to say that since they both have their first names. Anyways, and so is Owen Craft and Owen Miles, but anyways, we're gonna start round 4 now. And yeah, let's get through the command to fire the engines, folks. Engines have been fired for the second 2021 road course race for DRL Geico Elimination Series to start off round 4, as the pace car is pulling off here at New York to where Watkins Glen is located. And we're about to get things started for round 4 for the DRL Geico Elimination Series. So, I mean, Charlie Davenport seems to have a good position for the front row, so if he keeps it that way, he'll definitely get more points. Or even better yet, a win. But anyways, pace car is getting out back to pit lane already, as we're starting the show for round 4 of DRL Geico Elimination Series. Green flag is out at Watkins Glen! Thank you. I'm just gonna go ahead and start commenting already. And also, by the way, we allow cautions for this one since Road America is bigger than Watkins Glen. That's why I had to do no cautions for that race, since it'll still take me longer to do over some replays and all that. And it definitely wastes my time. And wait a minute. Troy Devilport is pitting already. I really didn't expect that to happen, since I thought Devil was doing good at qualifying. Oh well. Anyways, we got Rory Robertson, a round one winner at Daytona, that he's leading by himself in his 121 car. William Brock is slightly trying to catch up to Rory Robertson, though. So he still has some time left to catch up to the leader. Also, this may or may not involve with a lot of passing, but if it does, then great. Maybe there's gonna be a lot of passing right before we reach to lap 14, and if not, then it's just mostly gonna be one driver that is gonna be lean for whole laps. Actually, mostly 14 laps in general, since I think he's... No, I'm pretty sure we get second to 14. I'm trying so hard not to make this confusing. I mean, I shouldn't rush over things, but oh well. Guess I have no time to relax for the most part, since I'm ending up trying to record more races. And Troy Devilport is back on track. Good. Anyways, William Brock is still currently at second, but asking for Botter to try to catch up to Roy Wimbledon at the moment. So he's most likely stuck in this position with Roberto. Wait. Yeah, Roberto, Brendan Hancock, and Roger, the only three drivers that are behind him. This is most likely your top five standings. Let's check our cutoff drivers for a bit. Hmm. Well, I don't think these car drivers will be getting their good finishes at the moment. So, pretty much not sure what they'll do next, but right now we're seeing Brandon Hancock currently side by side with Roberto Crown Jr. Brandon wants to get to third, and he's got it anyways. And Roger James will also pass Roberto Crown Jr. 2. Just so that he will move to fourth. Wow, already with Brandon Hancock already going further away from these two drivers, since he is most likely gonna catch up to William Brock. And Jonathan Wong, I think, just got passed by Kelly Hancock. And he's gonna get passed by Owen Miles if he doesn't keep his position. But he'll most likely lose as the points leader. Damn, he actually got passed by two drivers. Well, I wonder who's gonna get the points lead next. Oh, well. It does quite take that a little longer for William Brock to try to catch up to the leader. But he's not just there yet. He needs to go faster a bit so that he can actually get behind of Roy Wilburton's car. You know, I did say that I wonder who's gonna be the points leader next. But you know, if Roy Wilburton won another race and ended up getting 100 points in first, then that will add up to 275 points for him. And if William Brock finishes second, I think he'll most likely get he'll most likely get 300 points. So I could be thinking, oh wait, let's check on Haley Hancock. No, Brandon Hancock first. Why did I say Haley, though? Oh, never mind. I confused the two names between Kelly and Brennan. Sorry about that. But yeah, if William Brock finishes second, end up get 90 points, and end up and add it up with 210 points to make it 300 points, then he will become the new points leader, I think. Since he'll most likely pass Brady Wilmington and Jonathan Wong. So, if he doesn't need a win, I think he's just most likely focused on points. If he wants to stay at second. It's up to him though. Either focus on the points, or focus on getting his first win. And my channel, for the most part. I knew we got a bunch of wins, but... yeah. Hopefully y'all understand that. Oh, actually, we only got three drivers that are pretty much going farther away from 13 drivers. But yeah, I think it's just the top three drivers: Roy Robertson, William Brock, and Brandon Hancock. But yeah, it's a good deal if Roy Robertson won another race, and then William Brock will end up get 90 points to add up to 300 points to become the new points leader. Also, yes, I am looking at the point standings. I should have done this for every races. But hey, blame my fat ass for being lazy to get the point standings next to me. Oh man. This is why I should have brought NR ratings whenever I do this. Since it'll be way easier to do, to focus on more racing. For the most part. Anyways. Were they really getting into each other? But let's see who the first driver can pass. Pass the next driver before we head to the last few laps, which will be the last three laps here at Watkins Glen. It was the last four laps from before, but now it's three laps to go. Well, since William Brock is still closest to Roy Robertson, he might be the next driver to try and beat the leader if he could try to pass him. I know, we could see Roy Robertson as a dominant driver, or William Brock, since he is going, since he's most likely to go for it, and they both made a little contact to each other, but that's gonna slow down Roy Robertson, as William Brock will get the lead for the last three laps, since it's most likely for him that he is most likely going to focus on his first win in the DRL league. It's a double win if he became the points leader and the first winner at Watkins Glen. But yeah, we're now at two laps to go. Can Roy Wimbledon get his lead back? Or will it be too late before we reach to the final lap? Or could William continues to block Roy Wimbledon so that he could focus on the lead and most likely get his first win in the DRL Geico Elimination series? We're about to find out. What's until we get through the last two turns. And then we'll get back to the front stretch. As we're going one lap to go, presented by the DRL League. White flag is out, folks. William Brock made his debut as the number nine driver from the Thanksgiving 500 race. He signed up for two special events, I think. And now he signed up for a short fun series that I forgot to add in the fun. As right now, Watkins Glen could be the only racetrack that he ever wanted to win out here at the Glen. But that's gonna be still surprising, as when he gets his first win, he'll be able to call himself the new place leader. And William Brock will get his first win in round 4 at Watkins Glen for DRL Geico Elimination Series. That is definitely something. Getting more points while he's currently at third when round 3 is done. But now that round 4 is done, he's done it. He's got his first win in the Cookie 2020 channel, if I haven't decided to change it to RX yet. And most likely will be the new leader. I forgot he's the I don't know if he's the previous points leader. But if he was from before, then I don't know, I don't have the technology to come back to actually, what am I saying? I don't know, my lazy ass doesn't really decide to do one or two things. My brain is broken. Anyways, besides my starving, here is your official results here at Watkins Glen. So first we got William Brock, second Roy Overton, third Brandon Hancock, fourth Roger James, fifth Roberto Crown Jr., sixth Carol Hancock, sixth Kelly Hancock, seventh Owen Crafton, eighth Cameron Hathaway, ninth Brandon Nelson, tenth Logan Williams, 11th Jonathan Wong, 12th Andrew Williams, 13th Sigi Rhodes, 14th Andrew Miller, 15th Brady Wilmington, and 16th is Troy Davenport. So, Brady Wilmington is most likely safe, except for the four drivers that I think they're still going to be below the cutoff. So, not a good start for these four drivers. But hopefully for round 5, wouldn't have done the same thing. And hopefully they will still survive when we get to round 5 soon. But yes, thank you guys for watching. Like I said, look forward to another Watkins Glen race that is going to be held for the Chips Ahoy Cup Series. And yeah, that's it. Congratulations to William Brock as the new points leader and the new round 4 winner now Watkins Glen. And I will see you guys next time. Peace!